Alright guys, we're gonna look at the Forester spoiler a bit, see how to get this off if you can and all that stuff. So the easiest first thing to do here is pop off this middle piece, okay? Now all it is a couple little push clips which go into these little holes, and your standard three punchies which go into your standard three punchies. First thing you do, take that off. Now these aren't really held on with anything else after that, so all they are is like one or two clips that go in these things. So you can take one off if you want, you don't really need to. I'm gonna leave this one on. I did that to make sure that there's no bolts that I'm not seeing over here, which there isn't. So although I have heard some people say that there are four bolts in this, with my own eyes, I'm seeing two bolts. I'm gonna get a flashlight too to see what I'm doing. One is there, and one is there. And I made sure there's none back here, because this is off. There are no other bolts. So it looks like two bolts, and the rest are all pop clips to see if we can get the spoiler off. Now, of course, you do have your brake light, which I would first disconnect this harness, and then I will pop it through that little circle when I want to take it off, and it should just pull right out. This is your washer hose, which is connected regardless of the spoiler. Can you see that? I don't know, it might be just for the reflection. Regardless of the spoiler, it's attached to the body itself. So you shouldn't need to do anything with this hose right here. So let me look a little closer at those two screws. There may be some blue Loctite or something, like the WRX spoiler, which was kind of tricky, super stuck, so I had to use heat on those. I'm not sure about these. Oh, of course my flashlight doesn't work. Hold on a sec. All right, this looks pretty basic. There's your bolts. Those are 10s. They look pretty solid, pretty easy to get off. So I'll go ahead and do those, and I'll do the brake line, and we'll see if we can pry this thing off. It's kind of scary. All right, the bolts come off very easily. It's loose already. I'm gonna use two hands because I do not want to drop it in there. It's super sketch. So I'm gonna try and just make sure I don't drop them. I'm gonna go super slow. All right, I got the two bolts out. Now the sketchiest thing of all, yanking on this frickin' spoiler. All right, almost worked up the courage. Got the brake light off. There's a pin right there, you can see. All right. I'm just gonna have to do it. All right, guys, before I start yanking, I might have found the two other bolts that someone might have been talking about. Now, I thought those were like roof rack type little spots, but probably not. Thank God I didn't yank it, and thank God you guys get the whole story now. These two little covers here, I gently popped them off. They came off real easy, and there does seem to be a 10 or a 12, it actually might be a 10, two 10s here. And these half, the spoiler ends there, these have to be going into this. So thank God I caught that one, and I'm going to get out two more bolts here. All right. So now I should really have all the bolts off. I can already feel that it is doing something. Let me get a tripod set up for you guys. Not quite as hard as I thought. Good, good. The brake light can come out too, because I don't know how the hell I'd wrap around that. Now I'm gonna give a chance wrapping this. Now every corner looks super easy, these curves, except for this one. The hard corners are really hard, and you're not gonna really have anywhere to stick that vinyl. Let me see if like this, where's the hard corner? Ooh, it's very visible, right here. So, that's it. Take off the rear spoiler. I'm gonna go ahead and get to work inside and start preparing this thing. Now starts the monumental cleanup task of this before I even think about vinyl. Hey guys, well, it's coming along. It's really hard to wrap. I mean, of course, this part, the top part's easy. And I got a bunch of flaws in there somewhere. You know, dots and stuff that I'm gonna work on. But I was actually kind of rethinking the design of this. I'm not even done yet. I haven't got the hardest part yet. And I'm thinking, do I really want to spend an hour getting these corners done? And I was thinking probably some razor tape for the top of the spoiler. This is going to be such a pain to do. I kind of want a topper on the spoiler, not the entire thing, because this is just going to take so many hours to get this right. So partly because of difficulty, and also I was thinking I wouldn't mind it coming to like a topper and looking like a shelf for the, you know, for the spoiler, trying to get the razor tape just perfect on there to get a good cut. I'm gonna rip this off, but I just wanted to show you how far I got, at least put it on record before I kind of changed my mind on it. You can see that it would probably look pretty good, but I'd just rather buy a black spoiler from the factory, from a Black Forester. I'm pretty sure they come in black. Actually, I don't know if I ever seen a Black Forester now that I think about it. Maybe they don't. I could have sworn you could get a black silica, whatever, spoiler ready to go But maybe that's why I haven't found one ever on eBay, because they don't even make that color. I don't know. All right, well, it's still a project. I'm going to keep figuring it out. All right, guys, let me just show you what I had in mind for the tape job. Can you see that green tape even? So we got, like, the top and then, like, around here. Basically, this is what it is, the top surface. And I took, like, a long time doing this tape, trying to get it about right. Then I'm going to do one final alcohol on this, put a much smaller piece of vinyl, which will also save money. Instead of having to wrap it all the way around the edges, I can get a lot more tries out of it. And I think that would look like a pretty good topper right there. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap this next. All right. Let me show you the final result. So, nice clean white borders. Pretty clean. It's not completely perfect, but also it's a spoiler. You're not going to see like slight stuff here and there like that. But overall, pretty cool. Pretty clean lines. The back is especially clean. No bubbles whatsoever. Just like a couple little specks of dust, but you can see how clean the back line is there. Pretty freaking sweet. I think that's it. The Forester Black Spoiler. Just the top. Yeah. Okay, I got to tap these little bolt hole areas. Stretch that a little bit, get that done, and I'm going to reinstall this puppy. And let's check out the final results. In fair disclosure, you see these caps? This one's clip broke off where it snaps in right, so I got some 3M tape in there right now, and I doubt they sell these little caps painted, which could be an issue, but I could also vinyl them black, which probably I'll do later, but I probably need to get one of these new caps right here. But check out the look, man. Wow.